Buenos dias, and welcome to the Messy Suitcase Travel Blog.
I'm Beto in Mexico.
And I'm Lisa, everywhere. And we're here to talk today about the awesome apartment that we have just rented in Mexico City.
We took a little break here in the States to take care of some personal family business, but now we're ready to go back to Mexico, and we've always sort of had in our mind heading back to Mexico City. And so that's where we're going.
So once we did that, once we knew that, we started researching Mexico City and what are the best neighborhoods. And we've talked to people who've been to Mexico City. I have friends who've lived in Mexico City, and we've done a lot of research. So we narrowed it down to a few of them. We also knew we wanted to be near a big park.
Be near a big park and close to some language schools, because
exactly.
One of the things we're going to do when we get back there is go right back into language school, you know, for a month of lessons to continue our Spanish improvement.
Right, and that's really important, and we like that it was within walking distance. But when it comes to the big park, we discovered when we were in Tlaquepaque how important that is as well, because we loved Tlaquepaque, but the big problem was there was no place for us to run. It was just all cement and narrow roads. That we finally found a park, but it took a whole mile to get there, and since we only run about 3 or 4 miles at most.
And a risk of life to get there.
Pretty much you got there, did a couple short loops and came back. So we decided it needed to be like when we lived in New York City, where we lived near Central Park and Riverside Park, so we always knew there was some place for us to breathe and to work out.
Yep, so we sort of centered our search on the park, and used the reliable Airbnb, and also we did some searches on HomeAway.
Yeah.
But eventually we came, we also have some requirements that other people may not always have, which is there needs to be pet friendly for our two cats this time, not the three, and parking for the truck.
Yes, and we knew we wanted a full kitchen, and I always like to have a little outdoor space if possible. I like to have a king-size bed if possible, but those both are negotiable.
Yeah.
And an horno.
Yeah, an oven.
Has to have an oven because Mexicans don't always have ovens, yeah. But we don't fry everything the way they do or deep fat fry. We like to bake it.
And since both of our kids will be coming down on their spring breaks, we're looking for two bedrooms.
Yep.
And they won't be there simultaneously together, but they'll be there sort of serially. So we want to make sure we had space for them.
And for guests.
So if you know us and you want to visit Mexico City on the cheap, you know, let us know, and we might have a bedroom for you.
Depending on when you come.
Yeah.
So the place that we found, we narrowed it down to three, actually. And I always do a lot of negotiating with the owners. We knew we were going to be there 2.5 months. And as a person who owns vacation rentals myself, I know that a 2.5 month rental of steady income without having to clean between or worry is gold. And so I always negotiate with them to make them pet friendly if they're not pet friendly, or to get an extra discount. And so I negotiated things like that and brought it down to three contenders.
Yep.
And the one we finally chose cost more than the others, but it just had everything.
Yeah, I mean,
it looks
beautiful. I can't wait to get there.
It's on Calle Amborgolo.
Whatever that is. But it's a couple blocks off of La Reforma.
La Reforma is the main tree-lined big avenue that runs through the entire length of Mexico City.
And a couple blocks from the park. So and a couple blocks from the metro stop. So
Chapultepec Park, the park he's talking about, is almost 1,800 acres of park. So it's more than twice as big as Central Park. And it's supposed to have great running. There's even supposed to be some riding there, so I think I'm going to bring my bike. And it has a zoo, it has 7 museums, it has a lake where I can go kayaking, and that's just a few of the things.
Yeah.
Like live music, you know, I mean, like free music outside on weekends, just like Central Park. And it also has this big boulevard coming out of it that's 2 blocks from us on the other side called Calle Chapultepec, which is one of the main places to go for bars and restaurants and things like that.
Yeah. And since we have to come back to the States in late April, early May, because our kid's getting out of college, you know, we know that there are 2.5 months in Mexico City is not going to be long enough, and we'll have to go back there
yeah.
at some future time, because there's just so much to do there. I mean, Mexico City is huge; it's massive, you know. So
yeah.
You know, you can't just spend a week there and really get a feel for it.
But we'll start. So we haven't told you about the actual apartment. So the actual apartment itself.
We told them it had an oven.
It has an oven.
The most important thing. It has an oven.
It's not in a high rise. I don't think it's a very high building, no. Maybe five floors. It's the penthouse, so it's on the top floor, and it has a roof garden. It also looks like it has possibly a little interior patio space, which I'm hoping will be closed enough that our cats can use it as a place to hang out outside. It has two bedrooms. The king size, the master bedroom has a king size bed and a huge walk-in closet, which is nice to have a lot of storage.
Yep.
The second bedroom is also big and has a queen size bed and not a walk-in closet, but still a whole wall closet. It has all windows on the front of the building is all windows, which is the living room side, big screen TV, a nice L-shaped couch, which we could even probably stick guests on if we want to, but we'll have an air mattress as well. The kitchen is just a wall of a kitchen, so it's not a separate kitchen, but it has everything I need in it. And it looks like the dining room area is nice and big with a great big table I can use for counter space for cooking, a big stainless steel refrigerator. It looks like a beautiful kitchen.
And I think she's being optimistic when she talks about cooking because this place is centrally located. And
why
I think
would we cook?
Why would we cook? No, there's times. After a while, you get tired of, you know, at least I get tired of going out to eat every night.
Exactly.
I suspect we will not be doing a lot of cooking there.
Yeah, the deal I made with the landlord is to accept cats, and we will be keeping a blanket over the couch so that the cats don't damage it, because it's a brand new apartment. Many of them are not even populated yet. It's newly furnished, and he gave us 50% off the rent.
Yeah.
And we are one of, like, to the first three renters, since he just put it up on Airbnb, 50% off the rent. And the building itself does not have parking, but he lives a kilometer away, and he has an extra parking spot where he lives in a secure parking garage with cameras where you can lock your car and leave it there. So he offered us one of his parking spots. Since we only plan to drive there and park and then never use our truck again, we figured that would work just fine.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. Exactly. So.
So that's it.
We're pretty excited. Can't wait to go. We're hoping that the weather holds for us on our trip down. But we're leaving here in about 10 days. You know, take care of some more business here. But we're definitely looking forward to it.
Oh, you reminded me, weather.
Weather.
So the weather when we're in Mexico City is supposed to be nice and cool in the evenings, 50s. And then the days are
mid-70s.
So yeah. Really nice spring weather for the whole time that we're there.
Can't wait.
Mexico is very high, you know. It's mile high.
It's at least mile high.
And it's I'm at Mexico City.
It's like 7,000 feet.
Yeah, I think it's probably closer to Evergreen High. And it's surrounded by mountains and volcanoes, so we're also looking forward to doing a lot of hiking there.
Yeah.
But we'll talk later about all the activities we're planning on doing in Mexico City. Thanks for joining us to hear all about our lodging, and PM us if you're interested in coming for a visit. We'll see if we can set something up.
Don't forget to like this video and
subscribe to our channel. Thank you.